All right, the key question, why, Jessica, did you have a crush on Zach Gilford before you ever sat down here?
Tell me why.
Because you probably remember him from the Taylor Swift video.
But of course.
That plays nonstop in your mind and heart. We're going to show a little bit of it.
Golly.
So is that a good gig to get?
Smooching the Swift.
Yeah, you know, it's funny. I was so nervous. I wasn't
really?
Sure if her name was Taylor or Tyler.
Oh my God.
There was all this behind the scenes stuff. I just thought I'd get it wrong. They keep being like, how is that? I'd be like, Miss Swift is great.
Miss Swift
is so wonderful.
So how do you get that kind of gig? Is it an audition or are they?
Nah, she or her people called my people. That sounds so bad.
And she's obviously extraordinarily prominent now. This was earlier in her career. Did you know who she was when they called?
Yeah, I just didn't know her name. But yeah, no, I mean, especially then, I mean, she was huge then, but it, you know, she wrote the treatment for the video. She kind of comes up with, she writes all her own songs. So it's like, I mean, she's an artist. So it's always cool to support other artists. And it was an honor that she, you know, wanted me to be a part of it.
How was the feeling when you got on set that day and oh, by the way, Taylor's going to smooch you quickly.
You know, it was fine. My wife was in my trailer, so whatever.
Yeah.
But
yeah.
It's one of those weird things in Hollywood, kissing, whatever, you got to do that stuff. It's so weird, but so technical that it's so benign and more awkward for, like, probably the crew standing around watching you.
Yeah.
Well, there we go. We got that. And now this. This is a great idea. A new YouTube series called Lifeline. It's about an insurance company. You want to be with this insurance company because they can go into the future to prevent accidents so they don't have to pay claims. That's a hilarious idea.
Well, that's a very cynical view on it. I thought it was more so that we could save lives.
Oh!
Yeah.
Save
lives and not pay claims.
I thought it was just not pay claims the interpretation. Sure. The Rock's the executive producer. What's his involvement?
You know, he actually plays a cool, fun little cameo in it where he's a client of the company, and I think he just kind of brings, like, a pedigree to the project, and, you know, it's fun being like, yeah, I'm in a Rock project.
Yeah.
Right. but here's the thing that's interesting. We talk about this all the time. We're on the same lot as Netflix with their big building. Amazon has a different show every single day. All these different new outlets. Mm-hmm. YouTube trying to get into the game. YouTube, of course, built themselves on quote-unquote amateur videos. This is not amateur by any means. YouTube Red, what is all that stuff?
You know, it was really exciting when I was presented with this opportunity because, you know, like Netflix, when they started doing original programming, I was like, huh, what? I thought I'd just get DVDs from them, and now they are who they are. And so YouTube, they have such a built-in audience, and it is such a kind of that indie film spirit because it is just people who are like, I'm going to go make a movie. Mm-hmm. I tell young actors, filmmakers all the time, when they say, like, what can I do to get ahead? I'm like, go make something, put it on YouTube. And now to be able to make a cool project, a TV show on YouTube, it's really exciting. And it's just everyone had that kind of indie guerrilla feel the whole time we were shooting it.
All right, here's Zach at work. Take a look at this. It's called Lifeline.
Hey! Oh! Okay. Take everything out. Throw it on the ground. Your wallet. Car keys. Now.
Please don't hurt us.
Move and I'll break your arm. Miranda, your password is spare. Do you understand?
Oh my God. You're from that company.
I'm not resisting.
I'm not a cop.
Well, you're the insurance agent of all time.
Yes, you are.
We want to get a policy with you.
Allstate, exactly.
That's a funny idea. In the cheat in the series, is it known that this company exists and does this kind of thing?
No, it's kind of our secret. Everyone knows we have this perfect track record of saving lives. Mm-hmm. No one knows how we do it.
Right.
And we have the ability to jump 33 days into the future, and we can predict your death and know when and where it's going to happen, and then we have to save your life. Another cool kind of twist that throws in is I'm then 33 days in the future, and you're there, but you're 33 days older. I'm just an hour older. Mm. So over time, what's, you know, a year to you is really only like
Why
6 days to me.
Why 33 days? Is there a
That was the big question on set. And then at the rap part, like, we are like, why 33? Is that like the Jesus number?
Oh, yeah. Right.
I have a Pip 33 tattoo on my leg.
Maybe that was it.
And at the rap party, we asked the writers, we're like, so why 33 days? We're like, I don't know, it was just a number we grabbed.
Real quick, will Flo, the insurance lady, be on it?
Yeah. We're trying to get her for season 2. I mean, her quote is high. Like I said, this is kind of indie-ish filmmaking.
You get to place bets on football and all that?
Okay, yeah, exactly.
Show's available on YouTube Red. It's called the Corridor Digital YouTube Channel. Nice to see you this morning.
Thank you.
Thank you, Zach.